Hi there.
I'm Martin Grumet. It's Saturday, August 17th, 2013. I'm here in beautiful Boise, Idaho, and it's sunny with a little bit of thin cirrus clouds. Today I'm testing the Kodak Playsport ZX3. This is not my own camera. It's one that I borrowed from a friend. So I thought for variety I'd try this. I don't want to ramble on too much about features. You can learn those elsewhere if you compare this to some of my other cameras that I have. Well, this has a fixed lens, focal length lens. It's the equivalent angular field of 36 millimeters on a 135 film camera. Now, by comparison, since like the Nikon AW110, its widest wide is 28 millimeters, so this isn't as wide, which makes it less ideal for doing these first-person type videos. And of course, the Nikon has optical zoom. This has some digital zoom, but I won't be messing with that today. Okay, the ergonomics on this is sort of nice for one-handed use. It's ambidextrous. I can easily hold this in my left hand, and I am left-handed. The other cameras that are designed as still cameras first and also do videos are really mainly meant to be operated in the right hand. Okay, well, anyway, so I'm about to go into the water with this. This is only rated for waterproof to 3 meters, but that's okay because the pool's only 2 meters. So, into the water I go.
Okay, so now I'm out of the water, and of course, one of the reasons why I like to state the obvious that I've just come out of the water is because I want to test the audio, how it sounds coming right out of the water after being in the water. I mean, by comparison, well, the Nikon AW110 and the Panasonic TS3 have done very well. The Olympus TG2, which is one that I returned, is one that audio coming out of the water is one of its weaknesses. So here I am, still doing first person, and so I'm gonna take another little dip into the water. I'm at the side of the pool now where I can grab on the steps and makes it a little bit easier. Okay. Okay, so it looks like the waters are rolling off the lens pretty easily. I guess I'll find out when I look at this, but I don't see any clinging water droplets. Okay, maybe just another little underwater dip here.
Okay, by the way, as for settings, I have this set at 720p at 60 frames per second, so, and I also have the white balance set to the standard white balance. There's an underwater mode white balance, which probably works well underwater, but videos, other people's videos they've seen, at least when they're using that, once they're out of the water, the color balance gets rather ugly. So this is kind of the standard white balance. Okay, I think that's enough video for now. Okay, goodbye.